policy on how we go about the screening of nominees. And I just want to reiterate that policy. That policy we have agreed that any nominee with legislative background would enjoy the privilege that we normally extend to such nominees. And I can see this nominee is so clever that he emphasized he's been a speaker, not only a member of the legislature. So based on this, the procedure we have adopted is to ask the two leaders in the chamber, the Senate leader and the Senate minority leader, to speak on our behalf, and then I round up. Senate minority leader.
In your position as the chair. My name is Eyindaya Baribe. I represent Abia South, and I am the minority. Mr. President, let me say that I will have some discussion with you after. But I have also had a discussion with the Rivers Caucus, and they claim that they don't have a discussion with me. So I don't know whether you can let a member of the Rivers State Caucus confirm or not whether I had a discussion with them.
Policy was adopted consciously and overwhelmingly, and I will advise us that we don't shift the goalpost. We stick with it, and I know that maybe few of us may have reservation, but this is a democracy. So, minority leader, I want to believe that this Senate will not change that policy. We are going to stick with it to the end. And I want to advise that if you have anything to say, to convey the general idea of what you should ordinarily say, I would advise that you do so. Point of order, Senator Mohammed Goji. Even without things in the rule. So we adopt this because we should extend this privilege to the House of Assembly. I think there is nothing wrong in that. The present nominee is only going to be a beneficiary by chance. It's not designed we are not doing it for him. So distinguished colleagues, distinguished colleagues, he is going to benefit this, not because we came up with this policy to support him. We said so even before he came. So it's not like he's going to benefit because we are going to do it now. Any person, nominee who passed through a legislative house, and that will include State Assembly, House of Representatives, and Senate. So the Sungwi Senator, your friend is going to be a beneficiary of this policy. So Senate Minority Leader, please make your remarks.
We want for us to have a discussion after. This was with regard to this. But going forward, another reason why I wanted River State recognized was the impression that had been created by the way we treated the matter of Akwaibom, which we didn't want it to happen, that somebody is against somebody on the floor. Nobody is against anybody. In that case, we want to make a comment on my good friend, who is another donation from the PDP, having been 8 years Speaker of PDP and 8 years Governor of PDP and Chairman of Governors Forum of PDP.
Yes, correct. Well guided.
So now that we know that he has his DNA in PDP,
we don't have any problem.
We have no problems with him.
Please go ahead.
And only want to state that I have spoken to the River State Caucus, and they have asked me to please convey this message to you, that they expect that you are Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, which includes River State, which also means that whatever you can do as Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria in making sure that peace and security is sustained and maintained in River State, that you should please do so. And also, to always recognize, as a Minister of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, that I have had interaction with you, and you have told me that the Eastern Corridor, regarding the railways, that if you are returned as the Minister for Transportation again, that that will be your priority. Eastern Corridor goes from south-south all the way to north-east. As you're doing well for the Western Corridor, as you're doing well for Ibadan to Lagos Railway, that we want that same thing on this side, including Abo to Onitsha, so that we can move goods through the Ajaokuta Wari Railway. And to go further, to say, sir, let us also expect from you that the Nigerian railways will be done within Nigeria before we go outside of Nigeria to connect any of our neighbors, because charity begins at home. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Senate Leader.
Thank you. My only remarks here is to know that antecedents and in genetics, they also require some improvements. And I think what we are having is an improved improved genetics and a minister of transportation for the entire country. Mr. Chairman, my own real addition to this issue is that Honorable Chibuke Amechi, I had the pleasure of knowing him very closely because I was a member of the Transportation Land Transport Committee. And with him, we had gone on several negotiations up to China, and I have seen a lot of the work that has been done on the railway infrastructure in this country. I have made a lot of visits to the areas where he has worked. Now, for somebody who is new and not come into that position, I think it's going to be a quiet a drawback. So we thought that the president, in considering, will take him back to his previous assignment so that he can be able to reconnect with the initiatives that he has already started and to see them to conclusion. My only plea, you know, similar to what my minister has said, is that our own northwestern sector of the country, you know, are in the plan. Zamfara, Sokoto, and Kebbi. We learned that these ones are in your plan, but we haven't seen anything in the 2019 budget. So we are hoping that by this confirmation, if the Senate, in its wisdom, do confirm you, you will revisit, and we want to expect to see in the 2020 budget a well-articulated funding of the program that you are going to do to connect Zamfara, Sokoto, Kebbi access to national railway infrastructure. If we don't see that, then we know that you and us in that corridor, you know, we have put our own legs in the same trouser pocket. We'll sit down, yes. We'll sit down and really refuse to allow you to rest, you know, until that plan and that promise that you have made, you know, comes to fruition. Mr. President, with that, I would like to request my distinguished colleagues to allow Honorable Chibuke Amechi, in view of his legislative experience, in view of the agreement that we had, the same experience having been a former speaker for 8 years of the River State House of Assembly, to take a bow and vacate the chamber. I so move, Mr. President.
I make this statement because the nominee served as a minister of transportation and issues of interest have arisen. You are at liberty if you have any explanation, because he raised issue of Eastern Corridor that runs from the south to the northeast, from Port Harcourt to Maiduguri, that if you want, the distinguished colleagues, he is not under any obligation, but if he chooses to explain anything, I think it's an opportunity for him. If he chooses not to say anything, he can take a bow and go. So it's up to you. You can take a bow. Do you prefer to take a bow? No. Do you want to take a bow? Okay. No. Order, please. Honorable Chibuke Rotimi Amechi, the former speaker of River State House Assembly, please take a bow. But before then, is it the view of this Senate that the nominee takes a bow and go? Those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay.
Yeah.
Ah, the ayes have it. Take a bow.
And service to our country. We should, just to be the president, please.